While the rest of us are racing to get vaccinated, a Rochester company is racing to find 100 unvaccinated people without COVID-19 antibodies for a clinical trial.
And Laura, this is proving to be a challenge for Immanis Life Sciences, or Sciences, I should say. ABC 6 News reporter Devin Martin has a story about this research and what it can show you if you participate.
I think with our test, you got your vaccine, do you want to know more?
That's the question, and Immanis Life Sciences in Rochester is digging deeper to give you peace of mind in the pandemic if you want it.
It's simply, did my vaccine work, and how long will it last, and what about variant?
Immanis Life Sciences, in collaboration with Viriad, have a common goal, having nothing to do with the pandemic. That is, treating cancers with viruses. But when the COVID-19 virus started spreading, the company shifted its focus and asked, what can it do to combat the pandemic? The answer was a neutralizing antibody test. But what is it?
If you had COVID and you were recovered, you produced neutralizing antibodies. So how do you measure that, and what does that mean going forward?
That's the reason why Michael and his team are looking for 100 unvaccinated people without these COVID-19 antibodies, and to find out what your titer number is. Think of it like this. The higher your number is, the greater you are protected from COVID-19 and the many variants.
If you have a titer of 100 or 150 and higher, you have a high degree of inferred protection from contracting COVID. 1,200 to 1,500, you have a high degree of protection against the variant.
And finding what your titer number is, Michael says, can help you figure out if the vaccine is working in your body.
If you take the test again 3 months later, you can go from point A to point B and see what the rate of fall is.
So how does this test work? Well, Immanis Life Sciences is working with Olmsted Medical Center, and you go down to your doctor. You have your blood drawn on some capillary paper, and it evenly distributes blood on the paper. And Michael and his team reanimate the dried blood spot, and the test continues.
If we can be successful with the dried blood spot technology, that just simply means we're going to be able to offer it to more people.
Helping people find peace of mind during the pandemic. In Rochester, Devin Martin, ABC 6 News.